Hi, hello, namaskara. Myself Mahesh Prasad from Department of Physics. As you know, well, dear students, we are in a topic that is nothing but the thermal properties of matter, right? And today we will discuss about the continuation part of which we discussed so far. That is nothing but the black body radiation, as well as Newton's law of cooling and Stefan's Boltzmann constant and of its law, and how the wavelength as well as the temperature are proportional. And before discussing this particular scenario, I'll ask one question. Obviously, you might have observed the solar panel. This solar panel, which is made up of which color? You might have thinking that it would be black. And I'll ask one more question. Can I use a solar panel other than the black color? The solar panel which you observed so far, can I use other than black? And why that particularly we have to take a material as only the black? So can we get other than the black light? Can I use the white color solar panel? Can I use a green color solar panel? So is it possible? Yes, it is possible. The thing is, you are going to receive or you are going to absorb a very less amount of energy. So that we'll discuss in today's class. So why we supposed to consider the black? A black color whenever we are discussing about in terms of radiation, okay? And today we'll discuss about one of the concept called as black body radiation. By the way, what do you mean by radiation? We know in a previous class we discussed about three different modes of transfer of heat, like the conduction process, convection process, as well as the one more is radiation process. So what do you mean by radiation? The radiation is nothing but the transmission of heat will take place from one point to another point without affecting the medium. So which example I have given over there, like the radiation which is observed by your sun to earth, which is nothing but radiation, are you getting? Or the heat which is absorbed by your sun, which is nothing but a kind of radiation. So this is how exactly it says. Now, if I speak about black body radiation, we supposed to deal in terms of thermal energy. What do you mean by thermal energy? Thermal in sense what? It's a kind of heat. What do you mean by heat, by the way? The flow of energy from one higher order to lower order. So this is the basic concept we have discussed so far. Now, if I speak about the black body radiation, what it indicates? It's a body which absorbs all the radiation which falls on the surface. So basically, in general, we don't have an ideal in the sense. In ideal case, we can consider whatever radiation which falls on the surface. If it absorbs all the radiation, we can call it as a black body radiation. So in ideal case, we can consider this particular definition. But in general, we cannot expect whatever energy is going to fall on the surface, it can absorb. In the sense, there is a possibility of your energy can reflect over there. So that's what one more concept we have discussed about photoelectric effect. So that we'll discuss in next year. For timing, your job is to understand the black body radiation. So what do you mean by black body radiation? The radiation or the body which absorbs all the radiation, whatever it falls on surface. And one more thing, suppose remember, the amount of radiation basically depends on the three different factors. One is the nature of the surface. The one we can call it as the nature of the surface. And also we can say the surface area. Also we can say the surface area. And also the amount of radiation which falls on the body depends on the temperature as well. So, if the temperature increases, there is a more number of radiation can fall on the surface over there. So, this is how exactly we can think about a black body radiation. And also, there is a law called a Kirchhoff law. You can call it as a Kirchhoff law. Basically, how to pronounce this? There are two different ways of pronouncing this law. Sometimes we can heard that this is also spell it as Kirchhoff law, or else you can call it as Kirchhoff law. Okay, So before we get into this Kirchhoff's law, we supposed to deal few terms which is based on the law behind it. So there is a point we can call it as the word that is the emittance or emissive power. So what do you mean by emissive power, by the way? It is nothing but the total energy emitted per second per unit area. So how to define this emissive power of the body? So in the sense, you take one now any object, for time being I'll not speak about a black body. You take any other object other than black, and whatever amount of the radiation falls on the surface, don't you think the part of energy is going to absorb by a particular body over here? So that's what it's defined over here, in such a way that the total energy emitted, the total energy emitted per second per unit area of the body is called as what? Emissive power or emittance. So think about this particular definition and try to get the SI unit for this. We know the power, which is nothing but the rate of work done. So here the energy is nothing but the kind of work done, correct? So how to indicate or how to get the SI unit for this emittance or emissive power over here? So basically it is nothing but energy per second per unit area. So what I can say, that is a joule per second per meter square, or else you can go with the joule per second as a watt, because watt is the series of power over here. Or you can go with the watt per meter square. So this is how exactly you are supposed to get the SI unit for the emissive power over here. Are you okay? Fine. And one more term you have to remember, that is the absorptance or absorptive power. So similarly, here absorptive power, what do you mean by absorption? What do you mean by absorption? It's a kind of receiving something, right? So similarly, in terms of thermal radiation, if I speak in terms of the radiation which is absorbed by any particular body, so if I speak about this particular scenario, so there is a statement we can form in such a way that it is a ratio of amount of thermal radiation absorbed by a body. It is a ratio of amount of thermal radiation absorbed by a body to the total amount of thermal radiation incident on the surface in the same time. In a sense, it's a kind of instantaneous process. Whatever the radiation is incident on the surface, it should receive, right? It should absorb. So that's why we can call it as absorptance, which is indicated by a letter, small letter A, and is a emittance or emissive power of a body can be indicated by a letter, capital letter E, where E which indicates the emissive power of a body, not a perfectly black body. If I speak about only E, that is the emissive power of a body. And if I say about absorptive power, this can be indicated by a letter, that is nothing but A over here. So how to indicate this or how to define this? It is very simple. It's just the ratio of the thermal radiation absorbed by a body to the thermal radiation which is incident on the body. So this is what exactly we can find under the concept of absorptive power. And also, if we have the relation between the basic relation between emissive power of a body also to the absorptive power of a body, so there, if we have these two relations, we can call it as, it is nothing but emissivity, or we can also call it as emittance, which is indicated by a letter, that is nothing but the E over here. So how to define this, the relative emittance or emissivity over here? It's very simple. The ratio of emissive power. What is the emissive power? So this is the first case which we have discussed over here. What do you mean by emissive power? Emissive power is nothing but it's the total energy emitted per second per unit area. So if I speak about the relative emittance or emissivity, how to define this? It's a ratio of emissive power of a body to the emissive power of a perfectly black body. So this E which indicates what? Emissive power of just a body. Well, if I say If I say E with the B subscript, that is nothing but the B which indicates emissive power of a perfectly black body, whereas the only the E which indicates emissive power of a body, where E with the B subscript which indicates emissive power of a perfectly black body. So if I take just the ratio of emissive power of a body to the emissive power of a perfectly black body, which indicates emissivity, or we can call it as E which is equal to E divided by EB. What would be the assignment for this? Obviously, this is nothing but the emissive power of a body to the emissive power of a black body. There is no assignment left out, they will get cancelled. So there is no assignment for emissivity, as well as there is no assignment for absorptive power as well, because it is also a ratio, correct? The ratio of incident radiation to the ratio of absorbed radiation. So, and similarly, the one more law which is given by scientists called as the Kirchhoff law or Kirchhoff law. So you can find many application under this man, who is nothing but Kirchhoff. There are many applications, like in the second year you are going to have applications like in terms of current. Okay, so that we'll discuss in the next year. For time being, we'll discuss the things which is given by the Kirchhoff, which is based on thermal energy. Okay, so he has worked many many areas, like especially in physics, in terms of thermal energy, also in terms of electrical energy. So many things he has discussed. So for time being, we'll discuss what he has given in terms of thermal energy or thermal radiation. So according to him, who Kirchhoff, what he said was, it is just a ratio of emissive power of the body to the emissive or absorptive power, which is equal to emissive power of a perfectly black body at a particular temperature. How to define his law? At a particular temperature, at a temperature, the ratio of emissive power of a body to the absorptive power of the body, which is equal to emissive power of a perfectly black body. So this is the condition which is given by the Kirchhoff over here. Are you getting? So this is how exactly we are supposed to get. And if I re-enter this particular relation, what I can conclude here is that that is nothing but, can I write E by EB, which is equal to A over here. So E by E, which is equal to A, where A which indicates what? Absorptive power. Where E which indicates what? Emissive power of a body. Where E with the B subscript which indicates what? Emissive power of a perfectly black body. You think about this particular the relation, and your job is to compare the relation with respect to the relative emittance or emissivity. In the previous case, we have got E which is equal to E by EB, and just now we have got where A which is equal to E by EB. So can I say that at a particular temperature, so what I can conclude here is that that is nothing but A which is equal to E over here. So this, because E by EB which is equal to A, similarly in terms of relative emittance, E by EB which is equal to E, where E which indicates what? That is emissivity, and A which indicates what? Absorptive power. So this is how exactly we are supposed to get the basic relation between that emissivity as well as absorptive power. Okay, so what we can observe here is that basically we have used the black body. What do you mean by black body? The body which absorbs all the radiation which is incident on it. If it is so, we can call it as black body radiation. So that's why we are using a black color whenever we are supposed to receive any radiation from the sun, which is produced by a sun. Okay, so that's why it is better to go with the black color, because black color which can, which is having the capability to receive all the radiation which is transferred, which is transferred from the sun over there. Okay, so this is how exactly we are supposed to get in terms of black body radiation, and these are the amount of radiation can be absorbed based on these three different criteria. One which is nothing but the nature of the surface and the nature of area, also which is depends on the temperature of the body. Okay, so this is how exactly we are supposed to get over here. Fine. Well, dear students, we'll see the one more experimental observation which is done by Newton. So, according to this particular the experiment, the same experiment you are going to perform in the first year as well. That is nothing but Newton's law of cooling. So, by using this particular experimental observation, we are going to get the basic the relation between the logarithm of the temperature difference with respect to the temperature and how the graph is going to vary, and if the temperature varies, how would be the heat exchange will take place. So these are the basic concepts we are going to deal in terms of Newton's law of cooling over here. Okay, so according to this particular statement which is given by Newton, what he said was the rate of loss of heat by a body is directly proportional to, in the sense, the rate of loss is what the heat is going to decrease, right? So the minus dq by dt, there is nothing but rate of loss of heat with respect to time the heat is losing over there. So the rate of loss of heat by what? By a body is directly proportional to the temperature difference between body and surrounding, provided the difference is not much large. So the rate of loss of the heat of a body is directly proportional to the temperature difference between a body and the surrounding, where T naught is the initial temperature and T is the final temperature. So if the body, basically the definition of heat, what it says, it is the flow of energy from body at a high temperature to lower temperature. So if you take one cup of tea, so obviously initially your tea is maintained at a very high temperature. As the time goes, do you think the temperature of the tea which is there in a cup, will it increase or decrease? Obviously, as the time increases, there is a possibility of a decrease in temperature of a tea which is there in the cup. Correct? The same observation is done by Newton. What he says that there is a decrease in heat with respect to time, and which is directly proportional to the temperature difference between a body and the surrounding. In this particular scenario, there is a cup and tea. The tea initially is maintained at a very high temperature, we can call it as a body. And the surrounding which is surrounded by the cup, we can call it as the surrounding over there. Are you getting? So this is how exactly we can say, obviously the surrounding which is maintained at a very low temperature compared to the temperature of the body which is maintained inside the cup over there, which is nothing but a T temperature. Okay, so similarly the ratio or the relation that is a decrease in heat with respect to time, which is directly proportional to the change in temperature of a body and the surrounding. If you have some relation, but if I want to write with respect to some equation, I need to take one constant, right? So that will consider over here. So can I write minus dq by dt, which is equal to k into T minus T naught, where K we can call it as a constant for time. Are you getting? And one more relation we might have discussed in the previous class, that is nothing but the specific heat capacity of a substance. So what do you mean by that? That is nothing but the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of a unit mass of substance. So which is equal to C, where C it was the specific heat capacity. But if I want to write with respect to dQ, which is nothing but a change in heat over here. So what I can rewrite the equation over there. So can I write, if I bring this cambium to delta T or dT to the other side with respect to dQ, can I go with the relation that is nothing but, let us say it is equation 1 over here. And if I want to write with respect to specific capacity, so can I write dQ which is equal to Cm into dT over here. Are you getting? So this is how exactly it is over here. Okay. So let us say it is equation 2. Now if I compare equation 1 with equation 2, let us do the comparison. So let us do the compare equation 1 and equation 2 and write with respect to dQ and dQ. So what I can do over here, that is nothing but I can write K into T minus T naught, which is into dT, which is equal to Cm delta T. Yes or no? Yes. So if I write, that is minus dT by dT, what I can write or how I can re-alter the equation over here is very simple. So you bring this Cm to the denominator, so what I can write here is that K by Cm into T minus T naught. So this is how I can re-alter the equation over here, right? So we'll do that. So now what I do here is that for a given temperature, so can I write K and C and M as a constant? Mass of a substance remains the same, and C, specific heat capacity of substance, remains the same, where K is already have taken as a constant. So this whole thing, I will take it as a constant for a given substance at a given temperature. Alright, okay. So I make this whole thing as a capital letter K for time being. So can I write dT, that is a capital T divided by small t, is equal to, that is a K into T minus T naught, right? So when using this particular idea, what I can get here is that, so can I write the rate of decrease in temperature is directly proportional to the temperature difference between a body and a surrounding, which is nothing but, can I write that is d by dt, that is minus, is directly proportional to the temperature difference between this, or the decrease in temperature with respect, or rate of decrease in temperature is directly proportional to the temperature difference between the body and the surrounding. So this is one more relation we can find over here, right? So this is how exactly we can get over here, and we'll write that particular relation at top. That is the rate of decrease in temperature. The rate of decrease in temperature is directly proportional to what is directly proportional to the temperature difference between, it is a temperature difference between body and surrounding. So if it is so, what I can write over here, so this is the rate of decrease in temperature for a small amount of substance, but I want to get the total amount of substance, what would be the decrease in temperature? So how to do that? So there is one more method, we can call it as integration method. So what do you mean by integration? We are adding something, right? For example, there is a process from one point to another point. For example, if you want to go from one point to another point, so initially you will go from here to here, here to here, here to here. So it goes on and you will reach up to one destination. So instead of adding the process from one point to another point, from here to here, here to here, so we can do the integration method mathematically. That is, you can take up the one limit from here to here. So there is a one more process there we have, that is nothing but integration. So we'll take up help of that particular idea and we try to get what would be the total amount of decrease in temperature is taken place over here. Okay. So if I do we alter the equation, so let us do that. That is nothing but dT divided by if I bring this T minus T naught to the denominator, T minus T naught to the denominator, what I can do, we have minus K into dT, right? That is a capital letter K we have taken. Fine. So now there is one more formula we have integration. That is nothing but, you try to remember, that is nothing but integration of 1 by x into dx, which is equal to log to the base e into x. So your job is to compare the relation over here. So if I do the integration, both the side integration and integration, now here don't you think this is look like integration of 1 by t minus t naught into dt, which is equal to, where k is a constant you can take outside, that is nothing but the minus k integration of a dt. Okay, now the job is to compare the relation. In the place of 1 by x is there, in the place of x what we have, t minus t naught, in the place of dx what we have, that is nothing but a dt. So similarly, so what I can re-alter the equation here is that is nothing but log to the base e into t minus t naught, which is equal to what I can write, integration of a dt. So integration of a constant, that is nothing but integration of a, it's like 1 into dt. Integration of a constant means what? With respect to what we are integrating, the term should be there over here. So with respect to what we are integrating, that is nothing but a dt. So with respect to t we are integrating. So I can write, this is nothing but minus k into t over here. Okay. So this is how exactly we are supposed to get the relation. That is nothing but, and by looking at this particular idea, what would be the graph we can plot? So if you plot the graph in the y axis and x axis, in the y axis if I take, that is nothing but log t minus t naught up to the base e, t minus t naught versus temperature. If you plot the graph, will you get the increase in value or decrease in value in terms of a linear equation, which is represent the straight line equation over here? So now since we have a negative sign over here, you will get a linear equation with respect to the decrease in value over here, which means if I plot a graph versus log to the base e of t minus t naught with respect to temperature, as the temperature increases, what happens here is that this value is going to decrease. So this is experimentally observed value, the same scenario or same the experimental observation you are going to do in the physics lab. Okay, so that's how it goes. So if you have a confusion regarding whether it is possible to get this kind of graph, yes it is possible, and you are going to perform the similar kind of Newton's law of cooling by taking a calorimeter as well as a thermometer, and by taking the reading value you are going to have this particular graph over here. Okay, well, dear students, we'll see one more law which is given by one more scientist, which is called as Stefan's law. According to him, what he says that, according to his experimental observation, obviously all the laws in physics which is based on the purely experimental observation, it's not like some scientist has told something and we are following that. It's not like that. It's like the things was there already, they are observed it, that's it. So according to his observation, whose observation? Stefan's law. What he observed here was that the total energy of a heat radiated per second per unit area of a surface is of a perfectly black body, of a perfectly black body is directly proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature. So this is a experimental observation which is done by Stefan. According to him, what he says that the total amount of energy which is radiated per second per unit area of which body? Perfectly black body is directly proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature. So how I can re-alter this equation? That is nothing but energy is directly the energy emitted, the energy of the energy or heat energy radiated per second per unit area of a perfectly black body is directly proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature. Okay. So if it is so, what we can have for in terms of equation, how I can re-alter this? So it's very simple. It is E is equal to sigma into T power 4. This is called as sigma. Sigma which indicates Stefan constant. Whose constant? Stefan's constant. Because of the scientist who has got the relation between the energy radiated per second per unit area of a perfectly black body is directly proportional to how many times? Fourth power of the absolute temperature. So this sigma, which is given by Stefan over here. Now, this is the constant. There is some value for this. Normally, we can have the value of sigma. We can call it as we can get around 5.67. 5.67 to 10 to the power minus 8. What would be the estimate for this particular sigma we can have? Well, E is called as what? Well, E, which is nothing but it is the emissive power. Have you remembered this? Emissive power, that is nothing but the amount of heat energy radiated per second per unit area of a perfectly black body. What was the unit over there? Energy per second per unit area, that is nothing but the watt per meter square. And it is directly proportional to fourth power of temperature, which is nothing but what is the absolute for temperature we can have over here? What is the absolute for temperature? It's very simple, that is nothing but Kelvin. So now, this E value we have, it is nothing but watt per meter square. And if I bring this T power 4 to the denominator, which is nothing but per Kelvin power 4. So now, I can get watt per meter square per Kelvin power 4. So this is the exponent for sigma value. What mean by sigma over here? Sigma value is nothing but 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter square per Kelvin power 4. So this is the exponent for sigma. Sigma which indicates what? Stefan's constant. Okay? Fine. Now, if I plot the graph versus intensity of radiation, the y-axis, we can take the intensity of radiation with respect to the wavelength of a light. So the distribution energy of the spectrum of a black body. So the first value which we have got, for example, the radiation or this particular intensity of radiation with respect as the wavelength increases. So this is a, by looking at this, this was a graph observed by some scientists. So the first graph, the first line, which is which we got with respect around 1000 K, it is 1000 Kelvin, and this is a 2000 Kelvin, and this is a 3K, and this is a 4K. So now your job is to observe the things which is there on the board over here. Don't you think it's a peak value? So this is a point where energy emitted is maximum. For this is a particular wavelength, that is the lambda m. For a particular temperature, a particular temperature like 1000 Kelvin. So this was the things. So at this particular point, the energy emitted is maximum. So now, don't you think for 2000 Kelvin, so this is the maximum value. For 3000, this is the maximum value which can emit the maximum radiation can emit a black body. So the distribution is not constant. Distribution varies with respect to the temperature. So as the temperature increases, don't you think the energy emitted by a particular body is also increases? And also you supposed to remember,
as the temperature increases, don't you think the maximum wavelength is decreases over here? So this is the increasing value. So this is nothing but, so this is the point where we have got, at what temperature we have got, this is the wavelength. At 4000 Kelvin, this is the wavelength we got, lambda m. This is the maximum wavelength which is emitted over here. Are you getting? So now, what observation we can make over here? See, this is for 1000 Kelvin, this is the lambda m. For 2000 Kelvin, this is the lambda m. For 3000 Kelvin, so this is the lambda m. For 4000 Kelvin, this is the lambda m. Lambda m which indicates what? Maximum wavelength. Now, what is the observation you can make here is that, don't you think, as the temperature increases, its wavelength is going to decrease? In the sense, as the temperature increases, its maximum wavelength is going to decrease. At the maximum wavelength, we can say, there is a maximum energy which is emitted by a particular body. So, yes. So now, what you can conclude here is that, as the temperature increases, there is a decrease in the maximum wavelength is going to take place. So this is the basic observation we can done in the particular graph. So by having this particular relation, one more scientist called as Wien's displacement law. Wien's, what is the displacement? Change in position. What is changing here? The wavelength is going to change. So wavelength is changing with respect to what? Wavelength is changing with respect to temperature. So as the temperature increases, don't you think its wavelength is going to decrease? So that's why the Wien's has given the displacement law, that is called as the Wien's displacement law. So according to him, what he says that the product of lambda m means what? The maximum wavelength at which maximum energy which is emitted. So this is a point where maximum energy is emitted. Is a product of lambda m and absolute temperature is equal to constant. So this is what exactly is done over here. So or else we can say the lambda m is inversely proportional to, or lambda m is inversely proportional to temperature. As the temperature increases, lambda m decreases. Maximum wavelength is going to decrease. So this is a basic relation. Suppose remember, either you can go with this or you can go with this. So this is how exactly we are supposed to get in terms of what? Maximum wavelength with respect to the temperature. Fine. So we have discussed about the black body radiation, Newton's law, cooling, Schiffman's law and Wien's displacement law. And also you have to remember the one more, the new formula we have discussed in terms of integration. That is nothing but this integration. So we have varieties of integration formula. For this particular case, I have used integration of 1 by x into dx. Okay. So this is what exactly we are supposed to deal in this particular chapter. And we will see the new chapter in the next class. Till that, thank you very much.